back to the book of Hebrews today, Hebrews chapter 6, and it's a bit of follow-up from the previous message, warning against falling away and moving on from milk to solid food. And now he actually tells us what those elementary things are. All right, so he says that as a believer, that we should move on from hearing the same message of repentance, of having faith in God, about instructions on baptism, laying the hands, and so on. And it's true. You know what? Sometimes we hear the same messages over and over. And this is what this whole theme, first of all, Hebrews starts with Jesus, magnifies Jesus. And he's now getting into our hearts and into our minds and say, hey, you cannot just remain infants and hear the same message, because if you do, you are going to fall away. An infant that does not grow is a person that's going to fall away. So he says, I don't want you to hear and have to hear, hey, you've got to repent, you've got to pray, you've got to be a person of faith. He says, we've got to move on and not just go and mull over the same things again. And then he goes on in verse 4, it is impossible for those, here's a difficult one, to who once have been enlightened, who have tasted the heavenly gift, who have shared in the Holy Spirit, who have tasted the goodness of the Word of God and the powers of this coming age, if they fall away, to be brought back to repentance, because to their loss they are crucifying the Son of God all over again and subjecting them to public disgrace. You know, this whole thing for me is such a warning against backsliding. Such a warning against backsliding. So the writer says, keep growing, because backsliding is a major issue. Go and read it yourself, verse 4, 5, and 6 of chapter 6. There's a warning here, as if once you've tasted and seen the goodness of God, and then you fall away. He says, it is impossible for you to come back, because you are re-crucifying Christ. You're actually making a joke of him, a public disgrace of the Lord Jesus Christ by backsliding. And it's a serious warning, this again. Remember chapter 5, the last couple of verses was a warning against falling away. And here he says why it is. Because we are making, it's a disgrace on the Lord Jesus Christ. So he says, once you've been enlightened, you better keep on walking in the light. You better grow in the light. You better become mature. You can't go back and forth and now back in the world and back in Christ and back. It doesn't work like this. That's the warning here. It is a very firm, stern warning against backsliding. All right? So I've said this before, but I have walked with the Lord since 1974. And I can honestly say to you that I've never backslidden in this time. Yes, have I grown a little bit weary from time to time? Absolutely. From time I just say, you know what, I'm tired. I really am muh when it comes to my faith. But never backslidden. Because this is one of the things that stick in my mind. If I've tasted the goodness of God and go back to Egypt, that's a problem. Then it says, land that drinks in rain, often falling on it, and that produces a crop useful to those from whom it is farmed, receive the blessing of God. And then the opposite is true as well. He says that if we produce fruit, we will receive a blessing from God. And then the last bit of verse 8, he says, but if we produce thorns and thistles, in the end, it will be burnt. So we've got to produce good fruit that leads or that follows our repentance. Verse 10 quickly here, because there's a lot of good stuff in this passage and you've got to go and read it and underline it. God is not unjust. He will not forget your work and the love you have shown him as you have helped his people and continue to help them. Here's such an encouragement to those of us who are really doing work of compassion in these days and helping others. He says, you know, God is not unjust. He's not going to forget that work. He's going to look at that, and he's going to bless you for it as well. And then verse 12, we do not want you to become lazy, but to imitate those who through faith and patience inherit what has been promised. Don't become lazy. So this whole last bit of chapter 5 and chapter 6, the first bit, is really a warning to continue in our faith, to grow and not to go backwards, but to continue to be fervent, to be passionate, to put in the work in our faith and in the works that God has called us as well. Because going backwards is not a good thing. Father, help us again. We ask in Jesus' name to not disgrace your Son by backsliding, by being in and out the world all the time, but to continuously grow. I pray for people who are listening today that we would continue to grow in our faith. and to produce fruit of repentance, but also fruit of righteousness, fruit that we show that we are maturing in you. And we thank you that you will bless those of us who bear much and good fruit. In Jesus' name, amen.